So I'm pretty familiar with cameras, but last week I got closer to a camera than I have ever been before, as I had one shoved up my butt. And when I say on my butt, I mean all the way up my butt. And that just gets to the point, okay? This isn't something I normally talk about, as it is mildly embarrassing, but I am talking about it because of that reason, because I don't want anyone out there to be too embarrassed to go to a doctor or get checked out if they are having a similar issue to what I had. Before I start the story, I just want to say, spoiler alert, I'm fine. I'm okay. I don't want you guys to worry. So let's rewind. Why do you have a camera up your ass, Phil? Well, this all started a month ago or so. I think time has no meaning at the moment. I'm not sure when it was. But it was when the world got the horrifying news that Chadwick Boseman had passed away, which I think hit all of us really hard. And I was watching a news report about it, and they listed all of the symptoms that someone might have if they have suspected colon cancer. Not necessarily saying if you've got one of those symptoms, you have cancer, but it's a warning sign you might want to get checked out. And I was watching it, and I was like, hang on, I've got two, maybe three of those symptoms. So first I was slightly denial-ish, like, I'm fine. Human bodies are weird. Maybe I accidentally inhaled a bee in my sleep and it's been stinging my intestines and that's why I'm getting so many cramps. But it didn't go away. So the first thing, obviously, what do? You go to Google, which says, you are dying. You are already dead. You died yesterday. So that didn't help with my sleep, which also spurred me on to make a doctor's appointment. But wonders of modern technology, I spoke to my doctor over Zoom and explained my symptoms, didn't have to show my butt on the camera. It was just a chat. She just referred me to a butt specialist. I can't actually remember the doctory term for it, but butt specialist sounds pretty cool. So a few days later, I got to the doctor's and I made peace with the fact that this was probably gonna be the Phil ass reveal situation. But what put me at ease is there was about eight other people all in the waiting room. So my butt was just gonna be another number in a sea of butts. I was not gonna be memorable to this person. Also, added bonus, we were both wearing masks. So I was basically a disguised ninja that was gonna pull his pants down. So I sat down with the doc, explained my symptoms. He gave a few nods, concerned eyebrows, and he said, right, let's have a look. So he said, go behind the curtain, pull your pants around your ankles, lie on the bed facing the wall. So me lacking any sense of direction, first thing I do is face the wrong wall, and then I realize he's not gonna have a view that he needs to have. So then he's like, okay, you ready? I'm like, no, wait a second. I'm just adjusting my pants. So I face the correct wall this time, butt out to the room, and the doctor walked in, and for some reason, at that moment, everything that was in my pockets set up a chain reaction and just dropped onto the floor. I don't know how I had so much stuff in my pocket, but it was like a pen, 7 coins, my phone, my AirPods, and it was just making a waterfall of sound. And then I thought it was over, and then one coin just went bing. So I broke the ice and said, you know what, you can keep all that. So first examination was just a little bit up the butt, which was fine. It took about 30 seconds and he said he couldn't see anything. It all looked normal. So the doctor left the room. I frantically picked up my 7,000 things off the floor. So I was like, phew, okay, I'm done. This ordeal is over. And then we sat back down and he said, Mr. Lester, I'd like to do a colonoscopy just to be sure. Anything with the word oscopy at the end is not my fave. So I was a little bit scared. He did say at your age, it is probably nothing, but I just want to make sure. I thought I was just going to go in the next room and they were going to get a bigger camera. But apparently a colonoscopy involves a whole hospital situation. And 3 days before it, you have to do something called the prep, which was a new concept to me. So apparently the average colon is 5 feet long. I'm guessing mine's longer because I'm a freaking giant. And they need you to fully clear out your system so the camera can get a good look around. So for 2 days I had to follow a very boring diet, which was basically just clear or white foods. And then for about 36 hours, I couldn't eat anything, which if you know me, was the biggest challenge I have faced. That night, I was dreaming of bagels with tiny hands just caressing my mouth. Alongside that, I had to take a prep drink, which basically flushes your entire system out. And I've got to be honest, that was not the funnest time. I gave it a Google and loads of people said it tasted disgusting because it was so sweet. But thankfully, being Captain Sweet Tooth, it didn't actually taste that bad. It just tasted like extreme fake lemon, which I could handle. Anyway, got all that out of the way and I arrived at the hospital, got a room. They gave me some little hot pants to wear and then a backless hospital gown. And that was when I made my second directional error of this adventure, because I didn't realise there was a butt slit, a privacy screen, as it were. It's basically there so the doctor can do the procedure without you having to have your whole ass on display. Guess what I did? I put the slit. I need to stop saying slit. I put the shorts the wrong way around. So things could have been exposed that I didn't want to be exposed. And then when the doctor went to get to the butt, there would have been some shorts there. Anyway, thankfully, I realised before the nurse came in and quickly did a whole switcheroo. And I was ready to go. Now, in different countries, they do colonoscopies in different ways. I think in America, they do it under general anaesthetic, but in the UK, it's either with sedation or they just go straight in with nothing. They said because it was my first time, they would recommend a light sedation, which I would be aware of everything that was happening, but I would be in a very calm, relaxed state. So I thought, you know what, after this year, sign me up for half an hour of light sedation. That sounds ideal. So I went into the room where the procedure happens, and I thought he'd be looking at a little screen through a scope, but there was a freaking 60-inch flat screen TV on the wall right next to the bed that I was lying on. So I was gonna have a front row cinema seat to this entire thing. Anyway, they got me ready with the sedation. They asked me if I was allergic to anything. I said I didn't think they'd be rubbing any cats on my butt, which made them laugh. So I was laid down on my side again, butt slit in the right place, and then the weirdest thing, the sedative started to settle into me, and I've never felt so awake yet so asleep at the same time. I was really focused on this TV screen, but I've got no memory of him putting the camera in. I've got no memory of any pain or discomfort. I was kind of just in a floaty state of half awakeness. But I do remember just staring at the screen and being mesmerized by what was happening, like I was watching some kind of medical TV show, but I was in it, and it was me, and it was in me. And I remember saying to the doctor, which seemed like a perfectly normal thing to say at the time, wow, that tunnel would make such a fun Mario Kart course. I think the doctor was like, yeah, mate, reduce the sedative a bit. I also know that I kept just saying, wow. Like it was some kind of amazing scientific discovery. I don't know. It was weird. I mean, it's kind of trippy seeing your internal organs on a TV screen. So it honestly felt like 5 minutes had passed when the doctor was like, all done, everything looks great, but it turned out I'd been there for 40 minutes. So I must have been just drifting in and out of consciousness and not even realizing that was happening. And then it was all over, and like a beacon of hope and destiny, in my hospital bedroom, they had left me a cup of tea and the biggest cookie you'd ever seen. I'm not exaggerating, but after so long with no food, this was literally the best cookie I've ever eaten. It was like the sweetest nectar sent from Jesus. Anyway, I had my cookie revelation. The doctor told me everything looked normal, so I should not worry, but he'd taken some biopsies just to make 100% sure everything was fine. Obviously, unhelpfully, my brain just goes, well, I guess I'm dying, as with everything like this. But after a few days, I got a phone call about my results, and they were completely clear. Everything was normal. Sigh of relief. I was fine. He said my symptoms could have been related to a new food intolerance. So I've just got to keep an eye on what I'm eating. And if I do start feeling crappy again, I can write a note of what it was and we might be able to figure it out. But generally, I'm feeling a lot better now. So I'm in the all clear, which was definitely good to hear. That rhymed. The whole scare was a bit scary, I'm not going to lie. But I'm glad I got it checked out and I'm obviously happy that everything is okay. As I said, I made this video because I did have that awkward, embarrassing, oh, I don't want to see the doctor about this feeling, but that is such a dangerous mindset to have. So if you've got any problem with your butt, with your boob, with your balls, anything like that, the doctor has seen hundreds of them every month and does not care. They're not embarrassed. There's nothing to be embarrassed about. And if you are feeling embarrassed, you can just tell the doctor you're embarrassed about it, and that would break the ice anyway. So I know not everyone has the privilege of seeing a doctor for free like I do, but if you can and you are worried about something embarrassing and you don't want to see a doctor, I would definitely recommend doing it. Because you've only got one of these flesh machines and you've got to keep it in good condition if you can. Anyway, enough about my butt. Thanks for joining me on this little story time. I'm gonna go order a massive pizza to make up for those 3 days of clear food that I had to endure. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're healthy more than anything. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.